Hello dear friends, our very own TOS is coming up with some spectacular event, Lac Remedies for Human Maladies, and it is going to be one of the lifetime experience, so be a part of this celebration. So what I am going to deal with is just a filling into this event on lacs, the unique adaptation of mammals and the production of milk. Suckling, the feeding of the young with milk. It is uniquely mammal activity. Suckling is a wonderful combination of both physical and emotional nourishment. It involves feeding the young, but more than this, it entails a physical contact between mother and the young, with the warmth and intimacy that this provides. This is what bonds mother and child. Milk as a medicine. From the homeopathic point of view, milks are very interesting medicine. It combines elements from two sources. People who need milk as a remedy will show issues and problems related to milk in general, but also issues related to specific animal source from which the milk comes. When the bonding between the mother and the baby is not fulfilling. For the baby, it can result in feeling of separateness, forsakenness, isolation, and estrangement. All relationship may suffer into later life, leading to the inability to bear touch and intimacy. This can give rise to fear of narrow and confined spaces. When the holding represents support and caring, of the baby is unsuccessful, in some way it can induce feelings of being let down, of falling to pieces and fear of falling. Another common theme is lack of trust, the bonding, the trust between the mother and the child. Stemming from a possible lack of bonding or warmth from the mother. There is lack of trust in life and in patient herself, and this comes from the lack of feeling of security occurring during the bonding in lactation. Many a times, lac patients are chilly, I have seen this. Lack of vital heat, support and security is the most important theme. Also, they can have fear of sharp objects or a sharp and critical tongue. The reaction to this stunned nurturing includes suicidal tendencies, eating disorders, undereating and overeating, cleaning, washing, compulsions. These are the things that you have seen, the cleaning and washing compulsions, themes of indifferences or lack of feeling, forgetting, mistakes while writing, dyslexia, speaking problems, and sexuality which is increased and decreased. With this common theme of the milk in the lac seminar, what I would be dealing with is some of the equine family, the equidae, the lac equinum, the lac acidum, which are the remedies that have been now lately used, widely used for many patients. They both belong to the equidae or equine family. The other remedy from this equine family are the zebra and the mules. Both are stubborn in nature. If assured that there is nothing to fear, they both will comply with your wishes. Once you trust, they are willing to companionable partners in work and pleasure. Both equinum and acinum patients talk about being in limited area. Confinement, restricted, small space. Both these patients describe about relationships in the form of companion and loyalty, the need to be loyal to the master, the need for a companion is a common theme which will run in both these remedies. Both will speak about duty bound, it's my duty towards the master, but the thinking behind it differs. what lacasinum would be for duty and what lac equinum will be for duty will be different. Lac equinum, horse have less tougher hooves on their feet than the donkeys. And what is the difference between the two? Is that the donkey, the need to be fitted with shoes. They are not preferred for mountain climbing. Patients having literally expressed the sensation of being nailed. This is what we see in the horse. Very restless on the face of danger. Patients express extreme anxiety about unknown fears of being panicked by the thought. Whereas in lacasinum, steady, sure-footed on the face of danger. They are very sure-footed. And if they sense danger, they will never move ahead. They sense danger from afar off and will not move an inch. By this quality, they are misunderstood as being stubborn. Rather, they are more intelligent than the horses. Whereas in horse, are very impatient and edgy. We find equine personalities are generally very jumpy, tensed, and with lot of vigor in them. They have got lot of energy. They have got lot of restlessness. And that is what we see in lac equinum. Whereas in lac asinum, donkeys are a calming effect as companions and hence are kept with horse or animals who are recuperating from an injury or race. And also with a show horse that is high strung and nervous, we find these personalities are more of led back and tolerant. Whereas in lac equinum, this vigor is expressed in human language in the form of animated, high pitch and hasty speech, very fast in talking. Many patients have witnessed using bad words very commonly. They are very abusive as far as the talks are concerned. Whereas in lacasinum, patients' expression is very slow. They are low, dull and grey. You need to really be patient in listening to these people. Lacasinums are very slow in their talk, unlike lac equinums who are hasty and fast in talking. In lac equinum, any type of water is okay to drink for them. They don't bother about cleanliness part of the story. Patients are not very fussy in terms of eating habits. But for lacasinum, they need clean, fresh water all the time. And if the water gets yucky, they will not drink, even to the extent of getting dehydrated. These patients are more cleanliness freak than the lac equinum. Dreams, for example, in the repertory you will see dreams dirt, delusion food is bad or dirty. Further, if you see in lac equinum, equine patients talk about swiftness of body, running especially near the water bodies or green lands, horsepower and strength. So they talk about lawns, they talk about where there is water bodies, they talk about running on a green grasslands. That's what lac equinum people will talk. Whereas lac asinum patients found talking more about load bearing, as if there is a heavy load that they are carrying on their back. A burdened animal by things which are not theirs and they want to kick it off. They have a feeling that this burden is not mine. Why should I carry this? I'm carrying this heavy load and I just don't want to do this. I will just throw it away. That's what lacasinum will be talking about. For lac equinum, description is more in favor of being tortured. Most tortured animal. Was used in wars, was used for traveling long distances, was used for farming, and forever it has been kicked, forever it has been beaten up, forever it has been nailed, forever it has been choked, forever it has been tortured. And this is what we see when the person's description talks about tortured, humiliated, being beaten up, brutally locked and chained. Whereas for lac asinum, description is more in favor of being confused, doubtful about can I trust these people or no, whether they are will be pure or no, is their understanding, is their feeling genuine or no, shall I go ahead or shall I wait over here. And this is the type what lac asinum would be. Further, in lac equinum, duty bound, if you see in rubric, mind, delusion, imagination, duty overdue, compelled to. I'm compelled to do more and more work. I'm made to do more and more work. Patient expresses their feeling of being used beyond limits. Somewhere I'm used beyond my capacity. Somewhere I'm used beyond my limits. One patient has expressed this in my practice, abuse so pitifully that even after dying, they prepare gum out of the body of horse. Glue, something that is made from the horse's hoofs. Whereas duty bound for lac asinum is, in the rubrics, delusion, work dirty and unimportant work does. They always express feeling of being worthless, useless, low self-esteem and stupid in whatever work or duty they come across. So they feel worthless, they feel very inferior, they feel low, they feel useless, they feel as if there is low self-esteem. That's what lac asinum will talk. Unlike lac equinum, where they talk about overdoing the work. They are made to do more and more work. They are used and abused for the human benefits. Further, miasmatically, if you go to see, lac equinum belongs to the malarial miasm. The rubrics that are there in lac equinum, if you see, is mind delusion, imagination hindered, mind intolerance, hindrance of, inflexible rules of, delusion pursued by police. Whereas for lac asinum, it's all about being weak, being accepting their weakness and the need to hide their weakness, and therefore from the psychotic miasmatic background. And we will see many of the speakers, many of the teachers who are there, who will be talking on various lacs, various milk remedies in the upcoming seminar on the 7th, 8th and 9th of September 2018. Make this celebration a grand one. Tell your friends, tell your colleagues, and therefore, if it is, it will definitely, I vouch, it is going to be benefit to all. So, with much more information on lac remedies, we are coming up with this unique combo speakers in September 2018. Join in with your colleagues and friends for once in lifetime opportunity. Thank you.